show her here!
I'm all for it. You know, I'm from Glenwood, right next door to Compton, so I'm more for like my community. Like my story is dealing with my son and knowing that there's a lot of children that are in the community and that are going the same way my son went. And it's not so more that, oh, well, he didn't come from a two-parent household. That's incorrect. Or it's a single mother. That's incorrect. Or you didn't raise me in church. That's incorrect. When you raise them with what you can, you give them what you can, but it's up to them as they get older how they take it, how they run with it. You know, another example, which is all over social media right now, about the young boy Junior who just got killed in the Bronx, you know, 15-year-old. So, you know, it's just because it's not here in California, we're not next to it, it's still a community, and it's still to deal with our children.
Yes.
So I'm speaking more for, you know, in the community as in sisterhood and dealing with what I'm dealing with. So that's part of my story.
Your story is your story, huh?
Right.
Great.
Yes.
And not even that I think too is that very important for us as the Orange panel understand is that everyone has to take their own ownership, even though we want to raise our child up and lift them and teach them, but they have to take their own ownership.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Ms. Jones.
Well, I would say for me, sisterhood is really about love. I was not blessed to have biological sisters. I was raised as an only child. So I really value relationships and particularly with women. I've been very fortunate to be a part of a very large organization, a sisterhood sorority. And I love them. But there are many other women in my life, such as Wanda and the ladies at this table, that I'm going to get to know and looking forward to our relationships growing. And it's so interesting when like minds come together. I was sharing with Cindy about a situation with my son who's having some health issues. And she, not even knowing him or met him, offered to meet with him and help counsel him in this journey that he's going down. And those are the kind of relationships that I want to see us build, to just encourage one another and lift each other up and just show love to each other, because we are, women can be so negative at tearing each other down.
Right.
I'm really about lifting us up, because we are all uniquely different. We're different. We come from different backgrounds, different education. And look at this table, all of our hair is different. Our views are different. But we all share the same as in our hearts and our love for Christ. So I'm just about uplifting women and empowering
women. And I want to add something to that, Ms. Burrell and Mrs. Jones. It's so ironic that you say that women are so negative and we dismantle each other. And you know, I do believe that it has to start with the families. When I say the word family, I have 9 sisters. I have 8 sisters, including myself. And most definitely, we were nurtured, we were brought up in a good environment. My mother raised us all by herself. But for some reason is that when there are a group of women, we are very dismantled. And this panel is about to speak your truth. Your truth is just what it is. And not only this is that I'm hoping through this panel is that I reach thousands of dismantled women. I'm hoping through this panel that God reaches deep in the core of us as the Orange panel to touch each and every woman and to agree that it's okay. We all are different. We all are different. We all are created differently. Your journey is not my journey. Your ways is not my ways. Your thoughts is not my thoughts. But at the end of the day is that I, Wanda, has to take ownership of what I need to take ownership of for me to be free of what I need to do to help dismantle women, to help abuse women, to help women that have been raped, to let them know is that we have a voice.
Mm-hmm.
and through the voices that we have to lift up those voices. And ladies, the part of this Orange Panel, we will have some people that we will step on their toes. We will have some people that will be very upset. But I will tell you something. The only thing lasts is what we do for Christ, right?
Absolutely.
And the truth, we have to stand on it. And I just had to touch on that, Rhonda and Anita, because I believe that for me, it starts with the family. Sisterhood starts with the family, because I have a group of sisterhood. I have 8 sisters. And so, therefore, is that when you speak your truth, it frees you. Mm-hmm. And so, I'm free. Ms. Thompson, what is it that you want to share?
To me, sisterhood, it's when I think of it, I have 3 sisters and we're all from the 5 of us. And to me, it's a commitment to an individual. And also accepting a person for where they are, but also in order to elevate them, you have to expose them to their potential,
absolutely,
the resources that are available. Yeah. Because sometimes we all get very complacent. And complacency, it keeps you stuck. But if you're not giving, someone may have a dream, however, they don't know how to reach that dream. Mm-hmm. And so there are steps that can be taken in order to achieve that. But sometimes, a lot of times it has to do with education, the environment, just a lot of entities within that. But giving the women the knowledge, the information in order to achieve those goals, those are key. So sisterhood, that's what sisterhood means to me. Because we're all at different points in our life. But you never want to be stagnant as a person. Because to me, you're not living, you're just existing.
And not even that, Tara, I would like to add with something you said. So you said some of us have no education, but I think that looking at a person such as myself is that no degrees, didn't graduate from the 12th grade, no money where my mother can educate me. But I think that education, it comes from within, from what you believe and what you can do. I think that there's so many people that have potentials that can take something out of no way and just build anything. You know, I'm looking back over my own life when I sat at the kitchen table in an apartment. I had nothing to build on. But I look back on God's mercy and His grace, what He has done for me today. I started a consulting company. I've started a property management company. I also have a house of second chances. Now I have a deli, and I look at Anita. She's a scholar of everything, and she has achieved so many different things. But I don't want the audience to think that because you don't have an education, you can't succeed.
Oh, right. No. And then when I was referring to education, and that could have been definitely in any
situation.
I just was talking about like the academic that can go to a 4-year university, because Rhonda's a realtor, so is Anita. So I'm sure that there were different things that you guys had to take courses or in order to get your license. So that's what I want. I'm saying education.
I'm just saying too is that we're the Orange Panel here, and we will disagree and agree on certain things. I'm saying that some cases that you don't go to school, you don't get a degree, you don't have, is sometimes a
sister!
Yeah. It was wonderful.